Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject Fluid Mechanics and Machines. And this is lecture number 7.1, 7th chapter, 1st lecture. The topic is Bound Layer Theory. So, in the earlier lecture, we discussed the viscous fluid flow or laminar flow, and we studied about the Reynolds number, laminar flow through a circular pipe, laminar flow between parallel plates, and cavity flow. And in this lecture, we are going to discuss about the bound layer formation, bound layer thickness, displacement thickness, momentum thickness, and energy thickness. So, the learning outcome to the students, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to discuss the bound layer formation, define the bound layer thickness, and derive the equations for displacement thickness, momentum thickness, and energy thickness. So, when the fluid is flowing over a solid surface, solid body, one layer of the fluid is sticking onto the solid surface. Then when you move in the vertical direction from the solid surface, when we move in the vertical direction, the velocity is gradually increasing. And at a particular point, the velocity will be equal to free steam velocity. So, the velocity u with which the fluid is entering the solid body, it is begin to flow, it is called as free steam velocity. When the fluid is flowing over the solid surface, so the velocity of the fluid particle on the solid surface is equal to 0, and when you move in the upward direction, the velocity is increasing. And this is what the velocity profile, how the velocity is increasing, this is given by the velocity profile. So the curve is the velocity profile, and it is increasing, and it becomes U, capital U. So the layer of the fluid, so the very thin layer of the fluid where the velocity is changing, it is called as boundary layer. A very thin layer of fluid called the boundary layer adjacent to the solid boundary, where the variation of velocity from 0 at the solid boundary to the free steam velocity in the direction normal to the solid boundary takes place. So, within the dotted line. So, the dotted line is called as boundary layer. And within the dotted line, between the solid surface and the boundary layer, the velocity is changing. And outside the boundary layer, the velocity is equal to free steam velocity. Within the boundary layer, in this region, viscosity of the fluid causes the appreciable velocity gradient, and hence the fluid exerts a shear stress on the wall in the direction of the motion. So, the decrease in velocity is due to the shear stress. Decrease in velocity is due to the viscosity of the fluid. So, you start from here, in the boundary layer. When you move towards the solid surface, you see the velocity is decreasing. And on the solid surface, the velocity is zero. The fluid sticking onto the solid surface is not moving, and it is sticking onto the solid surface. So, the decrease in velocity from the boundary layer towards the solid surface, it is due to the viscosity of the fluid. So, the viscosity of the fluid, it is retarding the fluid layer so that the velocity is decreasing. The value of the shear stress is given by the Newton's law of viscosity, tau equal to mu into du by dy. So, du by dy is the velocity gradient in the y direction, vertical direction, mu is the dynamic viscosity of the fluid. The region outside the boundary layer where the velocity is equal to free steam velocity and there is no variation of velocity and the velocity gradient is 0 and again shear stress equal to 0 outside the boundary layer, the fluid flow is called as non-viscous or inviscid flow. It is also called as potential flow region. Potential flow region. And the effect of viscosity on the fluid is negligible in the inviscid fluid flow or above the boundary layer, outside the boundary layer. And look at the diagram. This is the diagram which gives the boundary layer formation. So, we discuss the flow over a very thin flat plate, the fluid with the free stream velocity U, capital U, is flowing over the solid surface, the flat plate. So, as we discussed, there is a boundary layer formation. So, outside the boundary layer, the velocity is U, capital U. Inside the boundary layer, velocity is decreasing. So, velocity is decreasing from the boundary layer, the velocity is decreasing, and on the surface, the fluid particles are not moving, they are sticking onto the surface. And from A to B, this is called as laminar boundary layer, and this is called as laminar zone, and the tip A is called as leading edge, and the tip D, end D, is called as trailing edge. So, leading edge and the trailing edge. A to B is called as laminar zone, and the boundary layer thickness is called as laminar boundary layer. So, the thickness of the boundary layer EB is the laminar boundary layer thickness. And in the laminar flow, already we discussed about the laminar flow, the fluid particles are moving in a horizontal straight line. So, parallel. So, they are moving parallel and they are not interfering with the adjacent fluid layer. That is what laminar boundary layer, laminar flow. Then the fluid starts to change, the flow behavior starts to change, that is called as transition zone, where the laminar flow is converted into turbulent flow. So, for some time it behave as a turbulent flow, sometimes it behave as a laminar flow, and this is called as transition zone, and then it is completely turbulent boundary layer. So, the flow is turbulent flow, and the region is called as turbulent boundary layer and turbulent zone. So, we divide into laminar zone, where the flow is laminar, and the transition zone, where the change occurs between the laminar and the turbulent flow, and we have the turbulent zone, C2D is the turbulent zone, where the flow is completely turbulent, and we have in the turbulent zone again, we have a laminar sublayer very adjacent to the plate, and the corresponding thickness is laminar boundary layer thickness. And transition boundary layer thickness CF is the turbulent boundary layer thickness, or DG is the turbulent boundary layer thickness. So, we take another diagram. So, this diagram will give you a better idea what is happening in the laminar boundary layer and the transition region or turbulent boundary layer. So, for laminar boundary layer, the fluid particles are moving horizontally, and in the transition, so there is change from the laminar to the turbulent. And here it is, fluid particles are random fashion, they are flowing in a zigzag manner. And in the turbulent zone, we have complete turbulent layer, and you have buffer layer and viscous sublayer. So, the different layers, viscous sublayer, buffer layer and the turbulent layer. So, the laminar flow, transition flow and then turbulent boundary layer. So, these are all the three regions in the fluid flow. Now, you look at the animated view of the flow pattern of the fluid over a solid surface, and the color image that gives the vorticity magnitude. So, if you look at the blue color, there is no vorticity, there is no circulation, and when you find the red color, the circulation is more, and here at the beginning, so you may find the laminar flow, and then here it is turbulent. So, the turbulent, it is fluctuating, it is turbulent, and then it is at the back side, it is completely turbulent. So, this is the image, animated image of the three flow types, laminar flow, transition flow and the turbulent flow over a flat surface. Because of the disturbance, so there will be, you may find lot of circulation, and here you find lot of very low pressure. So, the pressure gradient will be very low here. And we have boundary layer thickness. We have to define the boundary layer thickness. So, boundary layer thickness is defined as the distance from the boundary of the solid body measured in y direction to the point where the velocity of the fluid is approximately equal to 0.99 times of the free stream velocity of the fluid. It is denoted by delta. So, delta is the boundary layer thickness, where on the boundary layer, the velocity of the fluid is equal to 0.99 times of the free stream velocity.
Next thickness we have to discuss is displacement thickness. So the displacement thickness is defined as the distance measured perpendicular to the boundary layer of the solid body by which the boundary layer should be displaced to compensate for the reduction in the flow rate on account of boundary layer formation. Because of the boundary layer formation, there is reduction in the mass flow in the boundary layer region. So for the adjustment of the boundary layer, the fluid particles are displacing. The thickness is called as displacement thickness. Displacement thickness is defined as the distance measured perpendicular to the solid body by which the boundary should be displaced to compensate for the reduction in the flow rate on account of boundary layer formation. This is denoted by delta dash. And we derive the boundary layer thickness. So the boundary layer thickness, it is also defined as the distance perpendicular to the boundary by which the free steam is displaced due to the formation of boundary layer. So look at here. So this is the boundary layer, and we are going to, this is the velocity distribution, and this is the diagram which we are referring for deriving the boundary layer displacement thickness. We take section 1-1. So we take section 1-1, consider the elemental strip. Y is the distance of the strip from the plate. Dy is the thickness of the plate, thickness of the small strip. U is the velocity of the fluid element, velocity of the fluid in the element. Actually, U is the velocity here, and B is the width of the plate in the direction perpendicular to the plane of the paper. So, B is perpendicular to the screen. Now, the area of the elemental strip equal to B into delta Y, B into dy, B into dy. B is the width perpendicular to the screen, and dy is the thickness of the elemental strip. So, mass of the fluid flowing through the elemental strip per second. So, rho into velocity into area. So, rho into u is the velocity, dA is the area, which is rho u b into dy.
When there is no plate, there is no boundary layer formation, and the fluid will flow with the constant velocity equal to the free steam velocity u at section 1-1. So, when there is no plate, then the mass flow rate through the elemental strip would have been rho into velocity into area of the strip. Now, the velocity equal to capital U. Capital U is the free steam velocity, and dA is the area, which is B into dy. So, rho is the density. The same formula, but the velocity is changed. The velocity here, it is small u because of the plate. When there is no plate, the fluid is flowing with the free steam velocity capital U. So, it is here, it is rho u into dA. The velocity u is less than the free steam velocity capital U. Hence, due to the presence of the plate, the formation of boundary layer. So, there is a reduction of mass flow through the elemental strip. The reduction in the mass flow through the elemental strip per second, so which is rho capital U into B into dy minus rho small u into B into dy, so which is rho B into capital U minus small u into dy. So, the total reduction in the mass flow between B and C for incompressible fluid, that you have to integrate. So, integrate this equation between y equal to 0 to delta, we will get the total mass flow rate. So, here B, rho is the density, B is the width of the plate, which is constant. So, we are taking out. So, y integral y equal to 0 to y equal to delta capital U minus small u into dy. Now, let the plate is displaced by a distance delta dash, and the velocity of flow for the distance delta dash is equal to the free steam velocity. So, loss of mass flow through the distance delta dash per second
is given by rho into velocity into area, where rho is the density, u is the velocity. Now, area equal to delta dash into B. So, where delta dash is the displacement thickness. Now, equating the two equations 1 and 2. So, we will get rho u delta dash B equal to rho B, and the integral 0 y equal to 0 to delta capital U minus small u into dy. And the rho B is getting cancelled. So, we will get, therefore, the displacement thickness delta dash equal to integral 0 to delta 1 minus small u by capital U into dy. Now, this is the equation. to calculate the displacement thickness, and the u is the velocity profile. So capital U is the free stream velocity, u is the velocity profile, velocity by which the velocity is changing within the boundary layer. So once you know the velocity equation for velocity description, velocity profile, then you can calculate the displacement thickness. The next one is momentum thickness. So momentum thickness is defined as the distance measured perpendicular to the boundary of the solid body by which the boundary should be displaced to compensate for the reduction in the momentum of the flowing fluid due to the formation of boundary layer. And this is denoted by theta. Theta is the momentum thickness. So because of the boundary layer formation, there is reduction in the momentum of the fluid. Because of mass flow rate is reducing and momentum is also reducing. So the thickness, so actually now the fluid is trying to adjust for the momentum loss. That adjustment is called as momentum thickness. So the momentum thickness is defined as the distance measured perpendicular to the boundary of the solid body by which the boundary should be displaced to compensate for the reduction in the momentum of the flowing fluid due to the formation of boundary layer. And it is given by theta. So once again we take the same diagram for deriving. So the same thing. So we have section flow, the fluid is flowing, consider the fluid is flowing through the elemental strip. Consider the section 1-1 at a distance x from the leading edge and take an elemental strip of y from the plate having thickness of dy. All the definitions are very much similar. And the within the elemental strip, the fluid is flowing with the velocity u. And here the free stream velocity equal to capital U. Now, the mass of the fluid per second through the elemental strip is given by rho U into B into dy. So, rho is the density, U is the velocity within the element, and B into dy is the area of the elemental strip. And momentum of the fluid equal to mass into velocity. So, mass equal to rho U B into dy into U. So, that is what the momentum of the fluid. Momentum of this fluid in the absence of boundary layer. So, mass remains the same. So, mass remains the same, but the velocity is changing. So, capital U. So, capital U is the velocity when there is no boundary layer. So, loss of momentum through the elemental strip, equation number 2 minus 1. So, rho U B into dy into capital U minus rho U B into dy into small u, that is equals rho B into capital U small u minus u square into dy. The total loss of momentum per second through BC for incompressible fluid flow, we have to integrate the above equation. So, integrating rho B capital U small u minus u square dy. So, rho B is a constant, rho B into integral 0 to delta capital U small u minus u square in dy. Now, let theta is the distance by which the plate is displaced when the fluid is flowing with a constant velocity u, and the loss of moment due to the displacement equal to mass of the fluid through the theta into velocity. So, mass equal to rho area into velocity. So, rho theta b into u. So, rho is the density, u is the velocity, theta into b is the area of the plate. And the capital U is the velocity by which for calculating the momentum. So, this becomes rho theta B into capital U square. Now, we have to equate the equation 4 and 5. So, rho theta B into U square equal to rho B 0 to delta U capital U small u minus U square dy. And simplifying, rho B is getting cancelled. So, we will get theta equal to 1 by U square integral 0 to delta u into capital U minus small u into dy, which is equal to 0 to delta integral 0 to delta small u by capital U into 1 minus small u by capital U in dy. So, this is the equation to calculate the momentum thickness. Here again, so you just look at the here. So, the earlier delta dash, so it is only 1 minus integral 0 to delta 1 minus u by capital U dy, but here the additional term is introduced, theta equal to integral 0 to delta u by capital U into 1 minus u by capital U dy. And once you, as we told already, once you know the velocity profile u, you can substitute the velocity profile here and integrate, you will get the displacement momentum thickness for the fluid flow. And we will solve the problem for this. We solve, substitute the velocity profile, we will solve the problem so that you can understand the use of this equation. The next one is energy thickness. Energy thickness is defined as the distance measured perpendicular to the boundary of the solid body by which the boundary should be displaced to compensate for reduction in the kinetic energy of the flowing fluid due to the formation of boundary layer. So, due to the formation of boundary layer, there is displacement thickness, there is momentum thickness, there is loss of, displacement of the fluid, there is loss of momentum, there is loss of kinetic energy. So, within the boundary layer, everything is within the boundary layer. So, the energy thickness we have to calculate, there is, because of the boundary layer formation, there is loss of kinetic energy. So, for compensating the loss of kinetic energy, the plate is, the formation, the fluid is adjusting itself. The thickness by which the fluid is adjusting is called as kinetic energy, I mean energy thickness, which is given by, which is denoted by delta double star. And once again, we take the same geometry for our description. So, you take a fluid layer, a fluid elemental strip at a distance x from the leading edge of thickness dy at a distance y from the surface of the plate. The fluid within the strip with the flowing with the velocity small u and the free stream velocity is capital U. So, everything is given here. And the mass of the fluid within the strip equal to rho u b into dy, and the kinetic energy of the fluid in the inside the elemental strip half m v square. So, half into 1 by 2 into mass equal to rho u b into dy into velocity square equal to u square. And the kinetic energy of this fluid element in the absence of the boundary layer, again mass into velocity. So, mass remains the same. Now, velocity equal to, in the absence of the boundary layer, the fluid will be flowing with the free stream velocity capital U square. So, rho u b dy into u square. So, loss of kinetic energy through the strip equal to, so the equation, first, second equation minus the first equation, 1 by 2 rho u b dy capital U square minus 1 by 2 rho u b dy u square. This equal to 1 by 2 rho u b into capital U square minus small u square dy. Now, the loss of, the total loss of kinetic energy of the fluid passing through the BC for the incompressible fluid, which is integral. So, integrating the previous equation 0 to delta 1 by 2 rho u b capital U square minus small u square dy, or we take all the constant outside the integration 1 by 2 rho b into 0, integral 0 to delta u into capital U square minus small u square dy. Now, let delta double dash is the distance by which the plate is displaced to compensate for the reduction of the kinetic energy. The loss of kinetic energy through the delta double dash of the fluid flowing with the velocity u, that is equal to half into mass into velocity square, 1 by 2 into mass equal to rho area into velocity, and velocity square equal to velocity square. Now, the area equal to b into delta double dash. So, rho into b into delta double dash, and u is the velocity, and the capital U square is the velocity square. Now, equating the equation 7 and 8, so we will get 1 by 2 rho b delta double dash u into u square equal to 1 by 2 rho b integral 0 to delta u into u square minus u square, capital U square minus small u square into dy. Now, rho b is getting cancelled. So, delta double dash equal to 1 by u to the power 3 integral 0 to delta u into capital U square minus small u square into dy, and rearranging the terms, the energy thickness delta double dash equal to 0 integral 0 to delta u by capital U, 1 minus u square by capital U square dy. And the three equations you ought to remember. So, the displacement thickness, momentum thickness, and energy thickness you ought to remember for solving the problem. It is very easy to remember. First equation is integral 0 to delta. So, delta dash equal to displacement thickness equal to integral 0 to delta 1 minus u, small u by capital U dy. The second theta, momentum thickness theta equal to integral 0 to delta 1 minus u square by u square dy. And third equation, you can find here u by u into 1 minus u square by u square dy. And these are all the books I published earlier in the mechanical engineering subject, design of transmission system, turbo machines, heat and mass transfer, operations research, gas dynamics and jet propulsion, thermal engineering and fluid mechanics and machines. Also, I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures for all the subjects. You can subscribe the channel and use the video for your better learning and to pass in the GATE examination. So, thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You subscribe the channel and you can write to me to my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. So, we'll meet again with another video lecture in the subject fluid mechanics and machines.